It's about your family, your friends, your passion, your peace of mind. The truly important things in life are yours to cherish and enjoy when you look after your health. That's why it's so important that women everywhere, especially those of childbearing age, learn more about thrombophilia.
Thrombophilia, it's defined as a disorder that's associated with an increased tendency to develop blood clots. And that's caused by like a genetic defect in the coagulation system, or it's acquired. So there's about 900,000 people every year will experience some form of venous thromboembolic disease. This is so important because if a blood clot develops in the leg, if you don't treat it, it can get bigger and even break off and go to the lung, and that can be life-threatening.
While some individuals acquire thrombophilia later in life, others are born with a genetic predisposition to thrombophilia.
Factor V Leiden is the most common known thrombophilic defect, occurring in about 5 to 12% of the general population. And even though factor V Leiden is common in the population, many individuals will never develop a blood clot. Antithrombin 3 deficiency is one of the least common forms of inherited thrombophilia. However, individuals who carry this disorder are at a very high risk, with up to 50% developing a blood clot in their 20s and 30s.
Studies show that more people die in the United States each year due to blood clots than from AIDS, motor vehicle accidents, and breast cancer combined.
So my experience with thrombophilia, it's been quite a journey. I was diagnosed with a bilateral pulmonary embolism when I was just 25 years old. It was quite an unbelievable moment in my life, because I was young, I was healthy, I was athletic. I knew this, it was very serious, and it was, pretty much life or death for me.
Like any health risk, when it comes to thrombophilia, knowledge is power.
My first experience with thrombophilia was when my brother passed away in 2006. My mom got tested, and that's when we found out that she had an antithrombin 3 deficiency, and then I also had the same thing. I went through a roller coaster of emotions and just had to make sure that I fully understood what this was and how I needed to deal with it for the rest of my life.
Women who are pregnant or who have just given birth are 5 times more likely to experience a dangerous blood clot, with the highest risk in the first few weeks after childbirth.
In pregnant women who have inherited thrombophilia, the risk of getting a blood clot is increased. So if you have been diagnosed with an inherited thrombophilic defect and you're thinking about getting pregnant, it's very important to speak with your healthcare provider about whether or not you need to be on medication to keep you as safe as possible and really prevent you from getting a blood clot.
During my first pregnancy, I felt some tightness in my calf muscle. So I spoke with my OB, we did do a scan, and it was a blood clot, and they were able to get it dissolved and no impact to my pregnancy. I did have to have antithrombin infusions for several weeks throughout my first trimester. And then I also had to have the antithrombin available for delivery. So I did have a successful natural birth, and I have a healthy child.
With the right medication, like blood thinners or anticoagulants and other treatments that do not affect the developing baby, women can enjoy a healthy pregnancy and birth experience.
There wasn't any hesitancy with having children. I aligned with the right doctor who took the time out to figure out my story and understand my symptoms. Once you have the right team in place, then you should be able to comfortably move forward with pregnancy.
If you're planning to become pregnant, particularly if you're aware of a family history of blood clots, talk to your healthcare provider first. Discuss your health history and your clotting risks, and learn more about the options available for treatment.
If you have a thrombophilic defect, of course that can be very scary, but as long as you work closely with your healthcare provider, you can manage it successfully and live a healthy life.
Thrombophilia gave me the opportunity to be a part of a community be engaged and be an advocate. When I think about the future, I think about raising my lovely children, striving to have some success with my career, and just giving back to the community and, just being a good person.
If you are not familiar with thrombophilia or any type of antithrombin deficiency that you may have, it is key to get as much information as possible. You'll definitely be more happy and successful in your pregnancy journey. I don't let my thrombophilia, I don't let the antithrombin deficiency slow me down at all. Our day-to-day is filled with a lot of fun and a lot of activity that I would not trade for the world.
Learn more about thrombophilia. Then go live your life with family, with friends, with passion, and with peace of mind. For details, visit stoptheclot.org.